Hello and welcome to our next video. In this lesson, we're just going to show how to set Git credentials, which is something that you'll need when you have a repo to make a commit. If it's not set, you'll get an error. And I want to demo what that error is for you right now. So don't worry if you can't replicate this part of the video right now. That's okay. I just want to show you what the error is. So in case you run into it later, you'll remember, oh, that's this error. And once you set your credentials, like we're about to do in this video anyway, and it will be in the next activity, you won't have to worry about it. But you would if you went to a new machine, right? So if I said git config dash dash global dash e, I'd edit, right? If I do dash dash list, I'm going to see what's currently in the file, which is just core.editor equals code with wait option. So my credentials are clearly not set. So if I said git add, which is the command to add, in case you didn't know that, to add files to staging, and then I said git commit dash m with some message like initial commit or something useful, I would get an error. It says author identity unknown. Please tell me who you are. And it tells you exactly what two commands to run right there. The global user email and username. So I'm going to go ahead and add those so that my credentials will be set going forward. So git config dash dash global user.name boba and git config dash dash global user.email and Boba Fett's email. Now you git config dash dash global dash dash list, and you see that now my username and email are set as expected. And if I do a git commit dash m with initial commit, I get the commit, and a git log shows that I was done by Boba Fett. So everything is done, everything is set, and my credentials are set. The only thing that's weird, depending on how you did this, and this is totally my personal preference, you don't have to worry about this, is right now, since I did the core editor first, my username stuff is at the bottom, I'm actually going to move that to the top. It does not matter the order, but I just want that at the top there in case I need to modify who's doing stuff later. That's right at the top. So there we go. That's all you needed to do in order to make sure that your information is set and working on your machine. And that handles your credentials. And that will wrap up this video. Thank you very much, and we'll see you next time.